Hey, what's up guys, and today I'm going to making this short brief video about how the late most promising Atlanta street rapper Bankroll Fresh was forced to pick a side between the Gucci Mane and Young Jeezy beef, which would spark a interest in the fans and musicians and producers to also pick a side too. Now Bankroll Fresh was becoming a rising star straight up out of the hot streets of Atlanta, and his buzz was becoming bigger and bigger as an artist as he grew. He was collaborating with many hot producers based in the rap scene of Atlanta, but the real reason why I made this video is because isn't it awkward how Bankroll Fresh had a mutual friendship slash music relationship with Gucci Mane before he was locked up.to now having a Billboard Gold certified record under his belt? Well, first, he started off rapping under the name moniker Young Fresh. He was featured on a couple songs with Gucci Mane, even his on his debut mixtape Trap God, which Bankroll Fresh featured on the hard ass banger collaboration with Gucci Mane and Young Scooter called Shooters. Bankroll Fresh was currently signed under the Atlanta rapper 2 Chainz record label Street Execs, which he would go on and start his own label named Street Money Worldwide, and that would take him to another level of rap. But around this time on December 3, 2013, Gucci Mane was charged in federal court with 2 counts of possessing a firearm as a felon. According to the federal prosecutor, Gucci Mane was in possession of 2 different loaded guns between September 12 and 14, 2013, and could be sentenced to up to 20 years in prison. On May 13, 2014, Gucci Mane pleaded guilty to possession of a firearm by a convicted felon. He agreed to a plea deal that would result in him being in prison until late 2016. According to the Federal Bureau of Prisons, his release date would be September 20, 2016. He served his sentence in the United States Penitentiary in Terre Haute, Indiana. On May 26, 2016, Gucci Mane was released from prison ahead of his scheduled September date, and this was due to Gucci Mane not initially being credited. But while Gucci Mane was locked up in federal prison, Bankroll Fresh would always shout out Gucci Mane or call for freeing of the 1017 boss man. He even made music videos dedicated to free Gucci Mane. Once Gucci Mane got out of federal prison, that's when harsh reality would hit the fan, causing fans and supporters questioning what if Bankroll Fresh was alive, would him Gucci Mane collaborate on more music after an altercation with childhood friend Atlanta rapper No Plug. Fresh was shot at Street Execs studio and later died at Hughes Spalding Hospital in Atlanta on March 4, 2016. It was reported that more than 50 shell casings were at the scene of the crime. No Plug later said in an online
studio to get yourself home. He comes out with like 10 or 15 dudes and he has his gun out.
Yeah.
So he actually point the gun at you,
yeah,
points the gun at you and shoots at you?
Well, I didn't see when he shot, but a hole hit like the door, the back door of the vehicle that I was in.
Okay, so he's shooting in your general direction?
Yeah.
Okay, so at that point you had your gun on you too?
Yeah, it was guns around.
Okay, and you shot back and he gets hit?
Shots was fired and he was hit, yeah.
So at that point, you jumped in your car and drove off?
We was in the car. I was sitting in the car when he fired the shot. So when he fired the shot, shots was fired back and I left.
No Plug later revealed that after he received news that Bankroll was dead, he called his lawyer, who also represents Gucci Mane, and went to the police. Here's what he said about his interaction with the police.
So the police review the video footage. They get your testimony. Did anyone on the other side testify or give their statements or anything?
Yeah, they say his own manager was like, he caused the situation. Like, his own manager, Ms. Ben told me, his own manager said that he caused the situation. And a lot of more folks said the same shit what I just said, told her the same exact story. So that's the only reason I didn't get locked up or none of that shit. I didn't even have to go to jail or none of that shit, you know what I'm saying? This shit lasted like, the interview lasted like 10 minutes, you know what I'm saying?
After the death of Bankroll Fresh, one incident would occur which would spark hate towards the rapper No Plug and 21 Savage. In this video you will see 21 Savage whisper in the rapper No Plug ear while he's performing to announce that he's responsible for the death of Bankroll Fresh, but No Plug would decline the action so he could keep performing at this venue. Fresh was also featured on Jeezy's hit song All There. The music video was released posthumously. Jeezy dedicated it to Fresh, filming the video in his hood with Fresh's family. But for some reason, why does it feel like Gucci Mane was jealous of Bankroll Fresh working with Jeezy on this song? I mean, even Gucci Mane is known as a street legend and trap god. He can also be a petty person also. In this video you can see the jealousy and pettiness in Gucci Mane face and attitude.
R.I.P. Bankroll Fresh.
Hey man, R.I.P. Fresh, he damn sure saved you on that one.
Damn so did, nigga, we platinum. What you talking?
It's unfortunate that we lost a young promising Atlanta street rapper who was heading to the top of his career lose it at such a short period of time. But as long as his music is still banging in the streets and the people and fans and supporters and family keeping his name alive, then the spirit of Bankroll Fresh will always be here with us to this today. Now I want everyone to like, comment and subscribe to the channel, and make sure y'all go bump Bankroll Fresh music so we can honor him for his contribution to the rap game.